Phantom, and welcome back, or welcome to my channel for another, I guess, like, PC reactions video or something. I can't remember which. And this is, hold on, I'm gonna go to my playlist real quick. Oh yeah, PC reactions. Oops. Okay. So, as you guys know, I've been watching a lot of, like, setup videos. I don't know, I just like watching a lot of setup videos for some reason. So, like, ever since I have been looking for a new setup, or, you know, like, hunting over the past couple of months, last year, I already have my PC, by the way, but I like doing a lot of, I like watching a lot of other people's videos, so I came across her channel, last year, I think, or this year, I think maybe last year. And, I started watching her setup videos, so, like, you know, this will be, like, reacting to tech hauls, or, like, reacting to hauls, and whatever, and, like, setup tours, and, like, all that other stuff, but, like, it's anything, like, PC related. So, like, it doesn't just matter if it's, like, a reacting to a PC tour or whatever, but, so she uploaded a new video yesterday, and, titled Another Gaming and Tech Haul, Peripherals and, like, Stuff for Streaming. So, I think I'll react to that first, you know, because it's related to PC. She has a bunch of, setup tour videos, actually. If you want to check her out, her channel is just
Caitlin. Hi guys, it's Caitlin. Welcome back to my channel. We're doing another tech haul today.
So, if you guys want to check out her channel is just KaityBoo, says die. K-A-I-T-Y. And just look her up on YouTube. I really like her videos. Mind you, it, like, it takes me a while to like, find YouTubers that I like watching. Watching people like KaityBoo Says Die, Noisy Butters, like all those types of people, because, okay, if you guys don't know this about me, I'm a super techie person, so, like, I love learning about, like, computers and stuff, and all that type of stuff. I watch a lot of, like, building videos. Mind you, I didn't build my computer. I know nothing about building PCs, but I like watching them because, okay, I don't know about, like, one day building computers, but it's always good to, like, learn new things about PCs and stuff and, like, staying updated because, you know, like, PCs are kind of like a nerdy it's like a nerdy thing. Like, I don't know. Like, I just get so happy when I see, like, setup videos, setup tours, peripheral, like, stuff on computer games, because I grew up as a computer gamer for 15 years, or, like, a PC gamer for 15 years. I know, it's been so long. I can't believe I actually started gaming that long ago, but believe you me, it's been that long, and I'm still as much of a geek, that I was, like, 15 years ago, so, yeah.
Because I can't stop buying cool things. I definitely don't have as much as last time, but I did buy some things. Some of them don't have boxes.
Like, okay, so, if you guys don't know this about me, I grew up playing a lot of video games, you know, playing on console a lot as well. I prefer PC over console, but I have both. I've used Nintendo, I've used Microsoft consoles. I don't have every Nintendo console under the sun. Like, I don't have a Switch. I want a Switch when it's reasonable, but I don't want one right now. Who knows, I may use it because I still use Nintendo stuff. I actually started on Nintendo consoles. Well, I started on PC first, and then I got Nintendo consoles, and then, you know, like, moved over to Sony. But, like, my thing is, if it's not that outdated, and if it still works, well, these are maybe a little bit outdated, but it's fine. Well, the originals, because they came out in, like, 2009, I think, or earlier than that. I know I got mine in 2009, so I've had it for a good while, but I'm not going to upgrade, because I like classic stuff, even though I have, like, you know, like, some of the newer Nintendo systems. I actually found one of my favorite games for Switch, and I'm like, I wonder, is it the same thing? Because I have, because if you guys don't know, I've used DS for, like, several years. I think I've had one since, like, the early 2000s. Can't remember when they came out, actually. I think they came out in, I don't know, maybe, well, the DS Lights came out 2004 or 2006, and I started gaming in 2006, so I think it was, like, the DS Lite, the DS, you know, the regular DS, which I still have one, I just don't play on it, because apparently after, like, getting something like a 3DS or whatever, your eyes get adjusted after a couple years. Like, your eyes and your hands get adjusted after a while, after a few years of having it. So, if you have, like, a regular DS, it just feels very small in your hands. Oh, well. At least, that's what it's like for me. But I don't know about other people.
Boxes, so they're not here, but I'll show you, obviously. But I have the boxes to the majority of the things. If you have a problem with buying things, specifically, like, keyboards and peripherals and whatever else.
Like, I totally understand, because, like, when you see new, like, computer peripherals or computer tech, you want to get it. Like, I feel like I'm gonna turn into that person that, okay, so I'm the type of person that likes wireless peripherals, just to make it easier on myself, because I like having minimal wiring. Plus, if you didn't know, if you're, like, new to, like, the whole PC thing, not a lot of people like a lot of wiring. Because cable management is really hard to keep up with. So, obviously, they go with wireless peripherals and maybe like store it somewhere like in little bins or something big enough to hold them. Because, like, that's what I do. I have like little bins to like store all my things. I may just want one for like peripherals and like all those things, or like computer accessories, and all that stuff, just to keep organized.
So today we're gonna go through everything that I have purchased recently. I did get some really, really cool things that I'm really happy with, though, so... And my last tech haul did pretty good, so... Definitely gonna keep doing them because I love talking about tech, buying tech, and making videos, yeah. So it's perfect, and if you guys enjoy it, then...
I'm a huge tech person. Like, I'm serious. I'm a huge tech person. Woke up a little bit ago, so if I'm tired, if I sound a little tired, it's because I am, because I just woke up. I woke up super early today, actually. Well, I took a nap yesterday. And then I stayed up until like 4. Went to bed and I woke up at 5. So I sound a little tired. That's why, but I'm fine. Because I get a lot of sleep anyways. Is like compared to someone else's sleep schedule. I'd say that my sleep schedule is perfectly fine because I get enough sleep. I don't force myself to be up when I don't have to be. I take naps a lot, so I'm fine. If you're wondering why I sound like this, as I said, I just woke up, so.
Before we get into it real quick, for one, I just wanted to mention that I am streaming on Twitch again, which is very exciting. I've been having a really great time. I've been streaming almost every day, so if you want to check out my...
Judy said you've been partying. I have not been partying.
I'll put the link in my description. It's the same as my YouTube. I've been streaming a lot of COD. I've been streaming some Fortnite, just as, like, memes, whatever, and whatnot, so that...
Okay, like, I'm not big on Fortnite, but, like, ever since Fortnite came out, which was, like, almost 3 years ago, like, people will not stop talking about Fortnite. I mean, I'm not that into Fortnite, mind you. Like, I really am not that into Fortnite. At all. Maybe because it's a newer game and it's just not my forte. but like, I mean, I don't know what the big deal with Fortnite is. Like, I still, like, it's been almost 3 years, and I still don't know the big hype about it.
That's been really enjoyable. I, like, set up my mic and a couple of other things at my setup I changed to, like, permanently have, like, a stream setup. So I'm probably going to make, like, a little video about that and how I, like, upgraded my setup for streaming, whatever. And as always, I just gotta say, if at any point you enjoy this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up because it helps me out so much. And if you want to see more videos from me or you just want to see more of my face, definitely subscribe and turn on the bell notifications to be notified when I upload. Now let's get into it. So I'm just going to start with the boxes. So the first thing that I have is the Corsair M65 RGB Elite mouse. I wanted a new mouse that was smaller and lighter than my SteelSeries, whatever it was called. I don't remember what it was called, honestly. Apex something.
Honestly? Okay. So, I'm someone who has gone through so many headsets in my life that, you know, like, in my career that I don't even use headsets anymore when I film videos. I feel like it would be a good idea to start using headsets again, but like, I don't need a headset with a mic because, you know, obviously you can get like a mic with a boom arm and just have like a wireless headset and a headset stand. Like, I've literally gone headsets. I've gone through two headsets in my almost 4 years on YouTube, and I've literally stopped using headsets for my videos, like when I film, so, like, it doesn't really bother me to not use headsets anymore, because I'm more of a wireless person now. Like, I like using wireless things now, so.
So I was looking at Corsair, and there was another one that appealed to me, but I ended up...
But yeah, the thing is, you don't always need, headsets when you're filming videos, but it's a good idea. Now, I recommend wireless headsets, like, you know, just, like, wireless headphones, and, you know, a mic, obviously, and stuff like that, so that you don't have to, so that it doesn't sound like muffled or whatever. That's practically how I'd want my setup to be, is just like a wireless, like a pair of wireless earbuds or headphones. Sometimes I don't always recommend wireless earbuds because they sound muffled. Beats are really good though. I love Beats. They're my favorite brand, actually. Like, nothing against Beats, but like, they're not, like, the earbuds aren't good to film videos with because they sound muffled. That's just my thing. And with a system like, well, not a system, but with a recording software, yes, which is the software that I've used for a couple years now. I kind of taught myself to use it. They have you know, things to tell you when your voice is too, like when you're being too loud, or when you're being too quiet, or when your voice is in the right range. So yeah,
I'm going with the Corsair, and I really, really like the white one. I wanted the white one so bad, but white just didn't really seem like fitting for my setup, so I was like really stressed, like, which one should I get? And then I figured the white one I could probably get away with because my desk is white and then my desktop is gray, so So I was like, I think I can get away with it. So I ended up getting the white, but I love this mouse. It's incredible. It's beautiful. It's really, really good. It glides so nice, and it has, like, different weights you can adjust, and it has a little sniper button on the side, so when you hold it, it lowers your DPI if you're, like, scoped in, which is really cool. And, of course, the IQ RGB software is really good, opposed to a lot of other brands, so I definitely recommend this mouse. It looks good in black, too, but the white was just so nice, I couldn't not get it. So next, we're just going to go right into it. Like I said, I may or may not have gotten the white. So, I discovered this keyboard by accident. It is called the Echo, I believe, 3084 keyboard.
Yeah, I found so many keyboards. So, I don't know what it is with me, but, like, I really like retro. I like retro keyboards for some reason. And, there's this place, I probably talked about it in a, Perfect video. Talking about peripherals, and, like the PNK Stuff website, the PNK Stuff brand, that was the brand that I looked up, because I looked up a ton of different, like, keyboard brands, and it was, like, this RGB, okay, I'm not, like, an RGB junkie or anything, but, like, as someone who works at night, who likes working in the dark, like me, like, you know, you have to be able to see where your keys are, so, for me, it has to be, like, backlit. I have to have a backlit keyboard, or I won't be able to see where the keys are. Macs are just naturally backlit. Computers. Well, except for, like, well, MacBooks are backlit. iMacs aren't. So as someone who has the most backward schedule, well, I've had the schedule where I work at night ever since I started YouTube. So, like, for the past almost 4 years. Well, I've actually been doing YouTube for 5, but really talking about it, but if you guys are, like, you know, OG subscribers to my channel, you would know that I actually started YouTube in 2016 and not 2017. So, in actuality, I've been doing YouTube for 5 years, but I've had a channel for almost 4. This channel will be 4 years old, July 15th of this year, so yeah, but for people like me that like working in the dark or have like a night owl schedule and they're always working, backlit keyboards, like backlit RGB keyboards, are gonna be, like, the best option for you, because, you know, you'll be able to see where the keys are and stuff and everything like that. So, I mean, I don't know, I just like RGB, it looks nice. Like the lights, naturally, because that's just how they're built with RGB lights in them, and then they have, like,
discovery. I'm a huge fan of TKL keyboards. I do like 60% and I have two of them, but the TKL layout is just better for me because I stream and just like having the F keys easier accessible and all the other buttons. But I like how these are all like condensed. Like my Razer Huntsman I mentioned in my last video, it's all spread out. This one just is so nice and clean. I wanted a clicky keyboard, so I was looking and I found this, and I'm like, was this like not made for me or what? Like it has all these different keys, tabs that it comes with that are purple and blue, which are my colors, and you can swap them out. Their logo is literally like a cute skull with headphones. I'm like, hello. Like that's so me. The box is even beautiful, like hello. And I didn't expect this to be like the greatest quality. I thought it was just gonna be like some weird Amazon brand because I've never heard of them. It was a little up there in price.
Okay, like the thing is, like not all Amazon brand keyboards are good keyboards. Like, I don't know, I would just want to go with, like, a good brand keyboard, because, as you guys know, I'm literally a tech freak. I'm such a tech freak, so I'd probably have, like, a couple keyboards, a couple good wireless keyboards laying around. I don't know. Like, that's just me.
It was like $120, but it's really good quality. It came with an amazing Type-C detachable cable with their branding on it. The keycaps are such high quality. The keyboard is heavy. It is amazing. I highly recommend this brand. Also, I'm going to have everything linked down below. Didn't say that yet. But I've really been enjoying that keyboard. I've always been a linear kind of gal, and I always get linear keycaps. So I wanted something different, so I got that, and I think that, like, for FPS games, it's, like, so much more satisfying playing with the clicky keys, and also that has Gateron green switches. You can get them with pink and orange also.
Oh, that sounds so satisfying.
So the next thing that I picked up is the Razer... Goliathus Extended Chroma RGB Mouse Pad. This was not the first one that I got. I wanted
I'm such an RGB junkie. Like, you guys have no idea. Like, I just think it looks so clean. It looks so nice. A lot of people don't like it, but me personally, like, I like RGB stuff, so it doesn't bother me. Like, I mean, I like lights, so it doesn't bug me in the slightest. And as I said, I work. I like working in the dark. I like working at night, so being able to see things is important without having like a ton of like backlit light on or like extra lights on. And it just looks nice. I like it.
I've always wanted a long RGB mouse pad because I have like that. On my desk, it's hard to find one that will fit. So I originally went with the SteelSeries one because I love SteelSeries, and I hated it. I really hated it because it is fiber optic, because it's flexible. It was so dim on the other side of the keyboard, and if you had any color with like any amount of red in it, like even purple or white, it would be like orange or pink or just some ugly color on the right half of it. Which this does do the same thing, but this one is way more evenly lit. So, if you're going to get one of these, Corsair makes a really, really, really nice one. Like the MM750, I believe it's called, or something. It has a USB hub. It's just way too big for my setup, unfortunately, but I went with this one. If you're going to get this one or the SteelSeries, definitely get this one. Like, and also the stitching along the bottom is way softer on this one. The SteelSeries one, like, hurts. So, yeah, definitely a fan of this. And also, I don't have the box for it, but what I did was I wanted, like, a space-themed RGB mouse pad, but I couldn't find one. So I ordered a just, like, space huge mouse pad. It was too big, so I literally cut it to fit on top of that mouse pad. So I can just, like, take it off if I want to, or just, like, have both. And it looks like it is RGB, and it's really nice. So that worked out really well. I was very scared, and I'm amazed at how well I was able to do it because I completely winged it when I cut it. But it worked out and it looks really good. So, especially with my new white peripherals. The next thing that I got, which I don't have the box for, is I got a USB hub because I've been, like I said, I put extra stuff at my setup permanently to stream. So I needed more USB ports. So I got the Anchor one, I believe. It was like the highest rated one, and I trust that brand. So I got that, and I just like stuck it under my desk.
USB ports are very important. I should know. Like, I have, like, I mean, after a while, your setup has like so many cords, so like having a USB hub, which is basically USB ports that you could like put under your desk or something like that, plus like clear up space, is pretty important because, as I said before, cable management is extremely important when you have a computer setup, or when you have a PC setup. It's very important, you know, to keep it clean and stuff.
And plug some stuff into it, and we're good. It was like $15 or something. Also, I didn't buy, but my sponsor, TechnoSport, which we all know I love so much, they sent me over one of their, like, chair circular pads for the ground, which I was really excited about because, like, a few days or, like, a week before they asked to send it to me, I was looking at them on Amazon, like, different ones, and I didn't really like the quality of them. They offered to send me that. I was like, wow, perfect. You read my mind. It came, and I love it so much. Just a beautiful black, like, circuit design. It has, like, a really pretty grip on the bottom. Like, it doesn't even matter if it's on the bottom, but it has, like, roses, and it's so pretty. And I love the way my black chair looks on it. I think it looks amazing. It's definitely good if you have, like, a hardwood floor so your chair isn't moving everywhere, or if you have, like, a fluffy carpet and you don't want the fluff getting in the wheels. My carpet is garbage, so I don't have to worry about that, but it just looks cool. But, yeah, it's really good quality. Like, things like that always smell, and I was expecting it to smell, but it didn't. That alone tells me it's good quality. The next thing that I got, it came in the cutest box, so I have to show it to you. It's a Nintendo Switch case. It came in the cutest little box. It's from Geekshare. I showed them.
Yeah, see, like, okay. Nintendo Switch, or Nintendo in general, is a very popular company, so maybe, like, one of these days, well, like, I'm talking years down the road, maybe I'll get a Switch. Like, years down the road, not now, because I'm fine with everything that I have, plus, like, finding a Switch is very difficult. So, like, when I'm able to, as I said, I actually want, like, a full-on game room for, like, all my games and stuff. Like, you know, not just my games, but my gaming consoles. Like, you know, an office/game room space. And all that type of stuff. So, when I have the room for that stuff, and if Nintendo still doing Nintendo Switches by that time, then I'll probably want to own one. So yeah, but like, no hate against Nintendo. I love Nintendo. Nintendo was like the first company I ever became obsessed with. And I have a lot of their products. Like, I love Nintendo. A lot.
This is not my last video, but 2 videos ago. It is just a little, like, Game Boy themed bag. You can use it as a regular bag, you can use it as a Switch case, but it is so cute and it's amazing quality, and it was like $17,
that looks,
I think.
So
it was
cute.
Really cheap. I don't remember how much it was, but I was expecting it to be way more, and it has little cards you can switch in the front. You have different designs, or you can make your own, and it's just so cute. I showed that in my Nintendo Switch.
pluses. I haven't seen like those DSi cases. I actually have one, but I don't have a DSi. I have a 3DS model, or a 3DS XL model. I mean, it still works fine, but it still works fine because the charger, well, they have like a little car charger that comes with it. And I mean, I'm sure it'll work with like, I mean, it works with like regular DSs and 3DSs. 3DSs are basically a DSi, but they have like 3D capabilities. So yeah, I actually don't have 3DS games, but I have 2DS games and they work. Well, not 2DS games, but I have like regular DS games. And they work perfectly fine on DS actually. Just have a very special spot in my heart for Nintendo. Probably because I've been using their products the longest. I've been basically using their products since 2008, so like 12 years now, I believe. But yeah, it's definitely worth it.
Collection video, but also I wanted to mention that because after I posted about that, GeekShare actually reached out to me and asked to send me some items to review for you guys, and I have them and I love them, and that's going to be the next video after this one, so stay tuned for that. They sent me a bunch of really cool accessories, so that's very exciting. I love GeekShare. The next thing I got, I don't know if I ever mentioned this in any of my videos besides my setup tour, I got the Razer Kiyo webcam. I had the Logitech, like, C920 or whatever Pro Stream webcam, which is really good and probably better than the Razer Kiyo. They just made the Razer Kiyo Pro, though, which has better specs. But I like that this one has a ring light and everything, and I love the way it looks, and I like having two webcams so I can, like, show multiple things. So I wanted a second one, and I got it really cheap at work. So I got that, and I've been using it stream, and I love it. And then I think the last thing that I got, I don't even know if this is like tech, kind of. I got a ring light off of Amazon because I had like this big ring light that made my life a living hell. I swear it was like the most, I would get furious every time I tried to do anything with it, and it was took up my whole room, and I had to move it constantly. It would break and fall apart. It was just terrible. And it was like $100 or something, so it was really sad. So I ordered this like small 12-inch, 10-inch ring light from Amazon. It was like $30. I just ordered a second one today because it comes on like a little tripod, but you can also make it big. So I recommend this to everyone who does any kind of content creation. It is amazing. It has a USB. I can plug it into my computer. I put it like behind this monitor in the corner of my desk, and it looks really nice there. And when I stream, I have the best lighting. It doesn't take up any space in my room. I can stand it up like this for YouTube videos. That's what I'm using right now. Love it so much. So I'm really excited to get a second one and put them, whatever. But yeah, that's everything that I got finally. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Again, everything will be linked down below. I love you guys so much. You mean the world to me. Hope you have a great rest of your day. Thank you for watching. Bye.
So that's pretty much it for this PC reaction video. Well, it's more of like a tech haul reaction, but as I said, this series has a lot to do with like PC reactions to hauls. like anything PC related. So I hope you guys enjoy. Be sure to leave a like, comment, and please subscribe to my channel, as well as subscribe to the channels that I react to for this series, because trust me, like, you guys won't be disappointed. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day. It's super early for me. It's like 7 in the morning now. I started filming this at like 6, so whatever, I can't remember, but you know, this video is like really long, but it's worth it, so with that said, I'm gonna go. I'll obviously leave a link down to this video in the description, and in the description, and I will see you all in the next video.